Hello everyone. Today again we'll be going through the subject mechatronics, and the last video was regarding A to D converters. Today also we will be dealing with A to D converters. Also we will be going through the points which are connecting with the last video. So again, objective of this video is to study analog to digital converters, that is A to D converters. And outcome is the student will be able to explain A to D converters or ADC. Contents of the PPT are introduction to ADC, types of ADC, and applications and selection of ADC. Out of these, first part, that is introduction to ADC, is already covered in last video. In that video, we have gone through basics of ADC, that is what are analog signals, what are digital signals, why analog to digital conversion is necessary, and how A to D conversion takes place in different steps. That was the content of the last video. So basically, in this video we will be focusing on types of ADC. So moving towards this point, types of analog to digital converters or types of ADCs, different types as shown on the screen are flash ADC, successive approximation ADC, dual slope ADC, and delta sigma ADC. So we will be going through these different ADCs one by one. So starting with the flash A to D converter, different elements present in the flash analog to digital converter are shown on the screen. The first one is priority encoder. So this is an important component needed in the flash A to D converter. Here on the screen in diagram, the shown priority encoder is of 8 inputs and 3 outputs. So it is also called as a 8:3 priority encoder. Priority encoders are again made up of logic gates, basically or mainly XOR logic gates are used here as a priority encoder. We will be going through logic gates in another video. Here we will be focusing on the work of a priority encoder. So what priority encoders actually do is, we are having different connections of input here. Here octal input is shown. So from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So total 8 inputs are given to this priority encoder. Again, clock pulse is also provided, or you can say input signal is provided for working of priority encoder, and it gives us 3-bit binary output. So here A, B, C will be the 3 bits of a binary output, where A is least significant bit and C is most significant bit. So based on the priority, priority encoder will give us an output. So priority encoders are logic circuits which give output code corresponding to highest priority input. What does it mean? Suppose out of 0 to 7 there are 8 inputs, 2 or more inputs are high, so which is to be sent as an output? So that will be again decided on the priority or highest value input will be sent as an output. So it is in descending order or maybe ascending order. So this is the work of a priority encoder. So out of many inputs, it will send one as an output signal. How these priority encoders work, we will go through it when we will be going through the working of a flash ADC. The second component or element is a comparator. Comparator nothing but it is an operational amplifier. We are going to use it as a comparator. Comparator name itself suggests it will be comparing two values. Here you can see to this amplifier there are two inputs V1 and V2 and one output, that is Vout. So we are going to provide two different inputs to two input terminals, that is one is inverting terminal, other is non-inverting terminal. So both the terminals of an op amp will be given with some voltages. So it will compare those voltages and accordingly it will give us output. So you can say here V out. So when there are two cases now, when V1 is greater than V2 is the first case, and when V1 is less than V2 is the second case. So when V1 is greater than V2, that is the first case when that is the voltage supplied to the non-inverting terminal is greater than voltage supplied to the inverting terminal, then the output given will be 1 or plus Vs plus. Okay, so that is the output given. So it will give on as an output. And the next case, suppose if V1 is less than V2, so the voltage supplied at the positive terminal will be less than the voltage supplied to the negative terminal, what will happen? The Vout will give us Vs minus, that is, it will not give any output or zero as an output. If we consider digital, so for first case it will give us 1 as an output, and for the next case it will give us 0 as an output. So it will compare the input voltages accordingly, it will give us the output. That is the next component, and the last component is voltage divider circuit. Okay, this is also needed in the working of A to D. How that will be seen from the next circuit. Okay, so this is the flash A to D converter. We can see here what is given here. So this is my 8:3 priority encoder shown here. This is the first component. So from right to left we can go. So this is first component, priority encoder, which is again having 8 inputs. So I0, I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, I6 and I7, these are 8 inputs which are coming from the comparators. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 comparators are used here. And again, so this part, so number of resistors you can see connected here. So this part is nothing but it is a voltage divider circuit. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 voltage, 8 resistors are connected in series here as a voltage divider circuit. Each resistor is having identical value. Here in this example, it is 1k ohm. Okay. So we'll go through the working of this first. So here again we can say 3 bit digital output will be available at the encoder or priority encoder here. So A0, A1, A2. So it is LSB, that is least significant bit, A1, A2. This is MSB, most significant bit. So this is enable input, that is we need to give input here for working of this priority encoder. Okay, so it is called as an enable. Then one of the inputs is grounded, as see number of comparators required will be calculated from this formula. So that is number of comparators required will be equal to 2 power n minus 1. So what is the output here? 3 bit output. So it is 2 power 3. So n is the number of bits. So output is required in 3 bits or 3 digits. So it will be 2 power 3 minus 1. So for 3 bit digital output, it is 7 number of comparators are required, and the resistors required will be equal to 2 power n. So resistors here connected in voltage divider circuit are 2 power n, that is 2 power 3, which is 8. So 8 resistors are required in voltage divider circuit, and 7 comparators are required which are connected to priority encoder. So you can see here the 0th input is grounded and other 7 inputs are connected with the 7 comparators. We already seen that comparators, how comparators work. So there are 7 comparators. Again, see here some voltage reference is provided through this voltage divider circuit. Here in this case it is plus 8 volt is supplied through this voltage divider circuit. Okay, and analog voltage is given at inverting terminal of this circuit. Okay, so basically how it's going to work here. Okay, so the reference voltage will get minimized at every junction, or rather coming from each resistor. So there is a drop of or this ladder of resistor will be used to step down the voltage bit by bit. So at every point we will get drop of 1 volt. So at the start it is 8 volts, then this is the drop of 1 volt through this resistor. So here we will get 7 volts. Again it will go through the next resistor, 6 volts, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and this is earth, that is grounded, 0 volts. So likewise there is a drop of 1 volt at every resistor. So at every comparator, at non-inverting terminal, we are going to get different voltages. So 7 volt for the 7th comparator, 6 volt for the 6th comparator, 5 volt is an input for the 5th comparator, and likewise. So at last, that is the first comparator, the 1 volt will be the reference voltage provided at non-inverting terminal. Okay, so at the inverting terminal we are going to supply analog in Vin. So whatever the analog signal or analog voltage we need to convert to digital will be supplied at this inverting terminal of each comparator. Okay, so suppose here I need to convert some voltage of 3 volt. Okay, so some voltage of 3 volt is to be converted here. So how it will work? So when I am going to supply 3 volt, so each and every comparator will compare the voltages. So here it will be 7 volt to, suppose the voltage coming is 3.5 volt. So here this will be 7 volt, this will be 3.5 volt. So it will give me 1, as the 7 volt is the higher value than 3.5 volts. That is, positive terminal value is having higher value than negative terminal. So this will give me 1. 6 again is greater than 3.5. This will give me 1. 5 is greater than 3.5. It will give me 1. 4 is also greater than 3.5. It will give me 1. So this, and this, all these where comparators will give me 1, and this, as 3.5 is greater than 3, it will give me 0 0 and 0. So 1 1 1 1 1, sorry, this is 0 0 0. So basically this will give me, so in ascending order this will be the first which is going to get from lower to higher. So that value will be supplied at the output. So this value 4 will be supplied here. So 3.5 is the input volt, and we are going to get here 4. That means here it will be 1 0 0. So this will be value 4 1 0 0. So it shows 4 as a digital value. So 3.5 is supplied and 4 we are going to get as a output. So again, for accuracy we need to go for higher resolution. So here 1 volt, as we can say again, so resolution is VREF divided by 2 power n. So reference voltage is 8 volt and 2 power n, n is number of bits, 3, so 8. So 1 volt is resolution here. So it will show only minimum to the 1 volt. So 3.5 it will show as 4 volt here, or rather it will give us 4, a digital value of 4 for 3.5 volts. So to increase this accuracy we need to go for higher and higher resolutions basically. So how this can be possible? So we need to increase the number of bits so that we can go for high resolution or high accuracy. But if we increase the number of bits, so see here, for 3 bits we need 7 comparators and 8 resistors. What if I need to go for 4 bits? So for 4 bits the comparators will be 2 power 4 minus 1, that is 16 minus 1, 15 comparators are required and 16 resistances are required. So likewise, as I want to go for high resolution, the number of components connected in the circuit will be more and more. So it will be very complex circuitry. Okay. So this is regarding the flash ADC. Then we will go through some disadvantages and disadvantages, or we can say pros and cons. So flash ADCs are actually fastest in all the types. Okay, because for one clock cycle it will give us one result. In one clock cycle it will provide directly the output, so it is called as the fastest. In the order of nanoseconds it will quickly give us the conversion, that is analog to digital conversion. Then simple operational theory, only the comparators and priority encoders are used. Okay, and speed is limited only by gate and comparator propagation delay. So basically speed is dependent on the priority encoder speed, that is gates, logic gates used in priority encoder, and comparator, that is operational amplifier. So basically these are advantages. It is fastest. Okay, that is main advantage. And the disadvantages are, each additional bit of resolution requires twice the number of comparators. As I already told you, for 3 bits it is number of comparators are 7, for 4 bit we need to go for 15. Again for 5 bit it will be increased. Okay, so nearly 31. Okay, so 5 bit is 2 power 5, which is 32 minus 1 31. Comparators, nearly twice the comparators are to be used, so the circuitry will become complex and it will add to the cost, that is it will be again expensive. Okay. Okay. Then again, as components are more and more, the matching components or the comparators and identical resistors to be manufactured and connected will be again complicated, and it is again prone to produce glitches in the output. That is one of the disadvantages. And again, major problem is with the resolution. It is having limited resolution, as we can go maximum up to 8 bits. Again, 8 bits means we need to go for 255 comparators. So that large number of comparators are to be connected in a flash ADC circuit, and that will be little difficult task. So though it is the fastest type of ADC, if accuracy is to be compromised, or if we need low accurate results, we can go for this flash analog to digital converter, as it gives us fast conversion. It is also called as a parallel ADC, parallel A to D converter. Okay, because all the comparators used here are connected in parallel with each other. Okay, so this was regarding flash A to D conversion. And we will go through the next different types in next video. So just for having a recap, in through different types of ADC we are going through. First one is the flash ADC. Flash ADC has three components, major components. One is priority encoder, other is number of comparators, and third one is voltage divider circuit. So for 3 digit output we need to go for 7 comparators and 8 resistors, which are all identical resistors, so that we can get reference voltage tape down at each junction, and it can compare between the reference voltage and analog signal voltage, and it will provide us an output. And priority encoder will give us the output which is connected with, or which has the highest priority in descending or ascending order, so it will give us the digital output accordingly. Okay. So thank you.